Wow, are they big. Wow. Hollywood, California, Jeff James. And his partner from Madison, Wisconsin, John Brewer. Their opponents this evening, from Metropolis, ladies and gentlemen, Teddy Long presents Dangerous Dan Spivey.
Let me get you straightened out right now. My name is not Teddy Long. My name is Mr. Theodore R. Long, and don't you forget it, pal.
I'm sorry.
Do you understand him, boy?
That's intimidation for you.
Yeah, it's easy enough to intimidate somebody when you're 6'9", 316 pounds.
Theodore Long presents Dangerous Dan Spivey and Sid Vicious, the Skyscrapers.
Yeah.
Whoa, are you kidding me? Look at the size of these guys.
Nah, there's nothing funny about this, huh? Spivey, 6'8", 318, Vicious, 6'9", 316, and they're with Theodore R. Long, and you better get his name right, because I don't see anybody out there that's man enough to fire this man now when he has these two big men backing him up.
He definitely has my attention now, no question about it. The Skyscraper, Dangerous Danny Spivey, starting out, and he's going against John Brewer. And I gotta tell you, anytime these fellas climb in the ring, they are gonna be the favorites to win a match. One tremendous mix tournament. Spivey, put a foot all the way down his throat and dump Brewer down on the mat. Catches him with a left. And just think, over in the corner is waiting a guy who is 6'9". Sid Vicious.
Spivey and Vicious. This, Teddy Long, has a big, big investment in this team. I had heard that Gary. Oh, look, there's Norman! My buddy Norman, look at this!
Oh, no. Norman, the lunatic, is at ringside as Sid Vicious drills him with a forearm. And that is an illegal weapon. It ought to be declared as such. This guy with a set of traps on him like I never saw in muscles and can kill you with that clothesline. Goes this time for the throat. Pins him down. And referee Tommy Young starts a disqualification count, almost backed him out for an early evening.
See, the fact of the matter is now, Teddy Long doesn't have one giant in Norman. He has three giants when you add the Skyscrapers, and everybody's after the big money in a two-ring battle royal. These are all men who want to bring into the NWA, yeah. Top 10. The Skyscrapers want a shot at the World Tag Team Championship, and I have to admit, when the Samoans finally, when the Samoan SWAT team does win the World Tag Team title, this is a viable contender for tag team. These guys are awesome.
Glad you'll admit it, Paulie. And there goes Jeff James sailing through the rope. Wait a minute. Sid Vicious picks him up at ringside and drops him on that metal fence. Vicious picks him up, lived up to his name, and dropped him right over on his throat on that metal retaining fence. Look out. Here comes Norman calling down. Theodore R. goes over to see if he can corral him back. What a team.
I don't know how my friend Gary Hart ever let this team slip through his fingers. I don't know. Maybe there was a deal between these guys, but Theodore R. Long has an awesome tag team now.
Big clothesline from Dan Spivey. He put James flat on it. Now on that. And that's humiliating. What's the excuse in that?
You know what he's showing? He's showing this puck, yeah. And all you need is a pair of tights and a pair of boots. You don't need them fancy looking tights. You don't need to be sending out for all these expensive looking outfits. You need to know how to wrestle. You need to know how to fight. And this guy is learning straight out that you have to learn how to fight. You have to learn how to wrestle before you buy the pretty looking outfit like he's wearing.
Standing right up on the throat, and the referee starts the count, and soon enough, Spivey just taking that 318 pounds and standing on the throat. Here comes
from the frying pan into the skillet, my friend. Dan Spivey to Sid Vicious, and the Skyscrapers are totally unbelievable.
You know what I find funny in that, in these two-ring battle royals? The Skyscrapers don't even need to throw anybody over the top rope. They are so big, and they just hip-toss somebody, the guy's over the top rope. They can just hip-toss you right over the top rope, and they could win.
That goes with anybody who happens to be in there, too, I would remind you. There's a tag back from Sid Vicious over to Dangerous Dan Spivey. Spivey takes it over. Neck, tags out to Sid Vicious, who slaps him down to his knees, adding humiliation into terrible physical pain. He is knocking Jeff Jane all around the ring, and no call. He could pin him 1, 2, 3, should he desire to right now. Look at him. He can't even stand up. He backhands him down. The referee says, he stops the match.
Trouble with that kind of action after the referee has already stopped the match. Let's go to a break.